Hello and welcome on back. I've been testing the PS5's USB C port and what you can do with it. I can say up front that the USB C port is a bit limited because of the firmware on the PS5. But there are still things that you can do with it. I'll save you the time because I'm going to check some of these devices on the USB C port. Let's just go on ahead and test them one by one. Also, please subscribe to the channel if the content helps you in any way because I'm trying to get this channel going. So, to start off, we have the USB-A to the Ethernet port. You must be thinking why I'm testing the USB-A port here. Well, this is mostly to get it out of the way, whether PS5 supports Ethernet over USB anyway. Also, if you lose access to the Ethernet port for whatever reason, and if you want to make it work with the other one, or if you want to go on ahead and do a pairing of two Ethernet connections on the PS5, I'm using the Surface USB-A Ethernet connector. And as you can see, unfortunately, it doesn't work. So we're going to move on and see if a USB-C to Ethernet dongle works instead. This is connected to the USB-C port. And as you can see, unfortunately, that doesn't work as well. And this sort of rules out that Ethernet pairing or Ethernet over USB is not going to work with the PS5. Moving on, we have the USB-C to USB-A extension. I'm just going to connect it to the PS5. USB-C extension is more like converting the USB-C port to a USB-A port, but it works in extension mode. And any accessory that is normally working with the USB-A type device should work with it. Here, I'm connecting a DualSense. And as you can see, it connects just fine. It's charging and all of the features work perfectly as well. Coming up next, we have a USB type hub, USB-C type hub, and this is a Satechi one. You can find others like this. Just make sure they're not cheaply made. There's multiple ports on this one. For example, the SDXC storage ports, and this is the USB pass-through port. I should put up a word of warning to not use these ports. I don't think the PS5 has a need for pass-through anyway. We've already tested the Ethernet port. No point in testing it again. And then there's the HDMI port. I recommend not messing around with that as well, because I've seen even if the PS5 had display port over USB-C support, it's not built in yet. Maybe with PSVR2, it might. The USB extension hubs will work just fine though. I'm connecting a USB Bluetooth dongle here, just to see if Bluetooth peripheral devices work with the USB-C hub. So right here, I have a Logitech Bluetooth dongle. This is a Logitech MX Keys keyboard, and the other is the Logitech MX mouse. Both of them are connected to the Logitech dongle in Bluetooth peripheral mode. And as you can see, they're functioning normally. Next up, we have the SD card. This is to check if a storage device works on the USB-C hub and whether you can connect it directly as well. But I'm just connecting it to the USB-C port in storage mode. This should work fine as well. But for that to happen, you need to disconnect your existing storage device because only one of them will work at a time. And at last, we have an audio accessory device, which is going to connect to the USB-C port, and it has a 3.5mm jack at the end. This is also supposed to work with the PS5 because the PS5 does support USB-C, USB headsets. I'm connecting a simple earphone to it and it has a mic on it as well. We're just going to see if it shows up. You can see it is detected as a USB-C to 3.5mm adapter and it also shows up as a normal audio device and input and output work just fine. Okay, to summarize, you can say that USB-C alt mode, which includes most of video and data modes, they're not going to work with the PS5, and it is probably a limitation of the firmware. So I don't recommend trying them with the PS5. If the cable or the device that you're trying to use with the PS5 is not well made or is incompatible, you might end up damaging the port or even the PS5. But the rest of the USB Type-A extension, like the audio compatibility mode and storage, audio access, should work just fine. Once again, please subscribe if this video has helped you and enjoy your PS5.